Hello student, good morning. How are you today? How do you feel today? Are you fine? Yes, you are fine, right? Okay, student, can you tell me how was your weekend? It was great, so-so, or bad? It was great. Okay, very good, student. Well, student, today we are going to talk about past progressive. Okay, repeat after me, past progressive. Okay, student, we use the past progressive to talk about action continuously happening at a certain moment in the past, okay? Bueno, chicos, el día de hoy vamos a hablar del pasado progresivo. Usamos el pasado progresivo para hablar de las acciones que están constantemente sucediendo en un momento acertado en el pasado, okay? Now, for example, pay attention. To make a sentence in past progressive, it's necessary to put the verb to be in the past. In this part, we have the verb to be in singular, am, is, and the verb to be in plural, that is, are. Okay, for example, what is the past of am, is? The past of this verb is was. The past of the verb are is were. Okay, student? Well, now, when do you have to use was? You have to use the auxiliary was, student, when you have as a subject, the subject I, she, he, and me. Okay? And when do you have to use were? You have to use were when you have as a subject, they, we, and you. Okay, student? Very easy. We use was with the subject that is that are in singular, and we use were with the subject that are in plural. Okay, student? Well, also, student, it's very important to know to create a sentence in past progressive, it's necessary to know about the gerund verb. So, what is a gerund verb? The gerund verb is the verb plus the ing. Okay, student? Bueno, chicos, ahora les voy a explicar en español hasta aquí. ¿Ok? Para crear una oración en el pasado progresivo es necesario colocar el verbo to be en el pasado. Am, is son verbos singulares, por lo tanto el pasado de am, is, was. Are es un verbo en plural, por lo tanto el pasado es were. ¿Cuándo usamos was? Solamente con los sujetos I, she, he, and it. ¿Cuándo usamos were? Usamos con los sujetos they, we, and you. Sujetos que son plurales. Muy bien, asimismo, chicos, es muy importante conocer qué cosa es un gerund verb, qué cosa es un verbo geriundo. Un verbo geriundo está formado por un verbo más añadido la ing. For example, in this part we have the verb work. Okay? To pass a gerund verb, this verb is necessary to write the ing. Work, working, trabajando. Watch, watching, mirando. Read, reading, leyendo. Eat, eating, comiendo. But in this verb, student, you don't have to add the ing. Also, no, pay attention. In this verb, student, you have to see if this verb has one syllable of intonation. So, if this verb has one syllable of intonation, you have to see if this verb ends in the consonant, vowel, or consonant. When this verb ends in consonant, vowel, and consonant, you have to repeat the last letter and then you have to add the ing. Swim, swim. Okay? So, pay attention in this verb. This verb has one syllable the intonation. So, you have to see if this verb ends in consonant, vowel, consonant. So, what do you have to do? You have to repeat the last letter and then you have to write the ing. Okay, alumnos? Bueno, chicos, ¿qué va a pasar cuando tú tengas un verbo que tenga una sílaba de entonación como el verbo swim, run? ¿Qué va a pasar? Vas a observar si terminó en una consonante, vocal o consonante, como es el caso también del run, del verbo run, consonant, vowel, consonant. Entonces, si terminó en una consonante, vocal y consonante, ¿qué vas a hacer? Vas a repetir la última letra y luego vas a agregarle la ing. Swim, swimming, nadando. Run, running, corriendo. Okay, well, now, pay attention in this verb. For example, in this verb, student end in the vowel E. So, when you have a verb that end in the vowel E, you have to erase the letter E, and then you have to add the ing. Okay? So, have end in the vowel E. So, you have to erase this vowel, and then you have to write the ing. Write, writing. Escribiendo. Have, having. Tomando. Bueno, chicos, cuando tú tengas un verbo que terminó en una E, ¿qué vas a hacer? Vas a borrar la E y luego vas a escribir la ING, como es el caso del verbo write y el verbo have. También hay otros verbos que terminan en E, ¿y qué vas a hacer? Simplemente borrar la letra E y agregar la ING. For example, I'm going to make two examples in past progressive. ¿Ok? Pay attention here. For example, I was watching TV at that moment. That is one example in past progressive. Pay attention in this part. You have the verb to be in the past, was. Okay? I use the verb to be was because I write the subject I. Okay? I was watching, look at this, the verb is in gerund verb, okay? This is a gerund verb, watch plus the ing. Okay, well, I was watching TV at that moment. Yo estuve mirando televisión en ese momento. Another example. They were swimming, okay, pay attention. They were swimming in the river. In the river yesterday. That is another example in past progressive because the verb to be is in the past and you have a gerund verb here. They were swimming in the river yesterday. Ellos estuvieron nadando en el río ayer. So, according to this example, what is my structure? What is the first thing that you have to write? Is the subject. Okay, in number one, the subject is I. In number two, the subject is they. After the subject, you have to write the auxiliary verb of the past progressive. The auxiliary verb of the past progressive is was or were. Okay, in number one, the auxiliary verb of the past progressive is was. In number two, the auxiliary is where. When do you have to use was? You use was with the subject I, she, he, and he. Okay? When do you have to use where? You have to use the auxiliary where when you have as a subject the subject they, we, or you. Okay? Well, after that, the student, you have to write the verb. Okay, you have to write the verb plus the ing. In number one, the verb is watching plus the ing. In number two, the verb is swimming plus the ing. Okay, well, after the verb, we have the complement. Okay, we have the complement. Number one, the complement is at that moment. TV at that moment in number two is in the river yesterday. They are the complement. Okay? Complement. Well, student, now I'm going to make three examples more. Okay? Now, pay attention here. For example, I'm going to write, I was talking too fast yesterday. Pay attention, that is one example. I was talking too fast yesterday. Yo estuve hablando demasiado rápido ayer. Okay? That is one example. Another example. You were working You were working hard last night. That is another example. You were working hard last night. Tú estuviste trabajando duro la noche pasada. Another example. It was raining. Okay. It was raining. It was raining last Monday. Estuvo lloviendo el lunes pasado. Okay, student, very easy, right? This class, this lesson was very easy. Well, try to study in your house. Try to review the video again, okay? And try to practice. Don't forget to do your homework. Goodbye, student. Have a nice day. See you. Bye-bye.